This is a reading of Brenda's blog, titled, This Isn't Who I Am, Is It? Dear ones, your need to be right is popping up in the most unusual places. You have worked diligently for months or even decades to create a special light. Even so, others are poo-pooing the results of those difficult transition tasks, as if your beliefs and actions have little value. So it is, many of you are confused about your current beliefs and actions. Were those actions valid, or merely an unrealistic dream state with little value or need? Perhaps those actions include ignoring friends or other parts of your world that seem unpleasant. Even though you wish to feel you are one with all, the decisions and actions of others feel wrong. How can that be if you're moving to love and away from fear? You are most comfortable in a world of consensus. Not necessarily of the entire globe, but within your friendships, communities, families, and countries. What is occurring is a division of 3D consensus and the creation of new concepts you are not yet comfortable with. How can you ever be one with others who do not believe or act as you do? Yet some of those you have written off are returning to your circle in ways you did not expect. This is a confusing time. Your new world is no longer linear. Circular is your new action word, and soon to be, belief. Even though that which was is no more, this new is different than you expected. In 3D, once you negated someone for whatever reason, that tie most often remained broken. You're discovering what once was is no more. So it is, you might return to friends you thought you would never interact with again. Or not. Your new world has very few clear divisions. The deciding factors of yesterday are no more. Your actions and beliefs change daily. So it is, you are flitting from belief to belief, action to action, and thought to thought. In 3D, clear-cut delineations were necessary to promote community thought. You are in a new place in a new time, discovering that nothing is clear regarding who you are or what you believe. That last concept is frightening because you're not used to the freedom of thought and action while of the earth. You're now exploring new frequencies, dimensions, beliefs, and actions in universal terms, as has been true since you were conceived eons ago. But when you were of 3D Earth, you limited your thoughts and actions to fit within the accepted parameters established by others to create a 3D cohesiveness. That 3D cohesiveness no longer exists. So it is, you're now exploring options you explored while not of the Earth. As you do so, you're discovering new possibilities, and for now, new fears. It is as if your personal world is exploding with ideas, actions, and interactions. Yet your 3D world seems the same. You continue to be angry at some actions of others, but that anger is dissipating as you move into new places and new worlds. And as you do, you surprise yourself with new thoughts, dreams, actions, and needs. Your need to be at one with others is no longer that important. Yet your days and thoughts are full. Even though there is no longer enough time in your day to do all you wish, you do not seem to be doing that much. Your new world is topsy-turvy. What once gave you joy likely does not any longer. What was once boring, likely is no longer. And those you decided you no longer wish to interact with seem to have changed. Or not. It is almost as if you have become what many label a walk-in. You are a completely new being, learning more about yourself daily. Many of those new pieces are confusing, for they feel right, even though they're counterintuitive to your former logic. This isn't who I am, is it? Seems to be part of your new being. Adding and subtracting activities and thoughts, second by second. Who am I? Was your refrain after you left 3D. A refrain that is becoming louder and louder. You are surprised, but not displeased with your new being, for you are likely calmer and more peaceful in your actions and thoughts. That which once frightened you seems to be further away, including people, places, and things. You're more comfortable letting others fret and become angry, for you no longer feel much need to do so. You find yourself ignoring uncomfortable pieces and perhaps encouraging your loved ones to do the same. There is little need for you to jump into any angry conversation or action. You're more comfortable doing not much of anything than forcing yourself to be something, as was true in 3D. This is who I am, and I don't feel much need to project anything else. A new refrain that is surprising you as much as anyone. When you're bored, you act upon it, and when you're excited, you do the same. All your 3D stops are being removed. And as that is happening, you question yourself. Not because you're uncomfortable, but because new you is different than 3D you, or how you expected to be in this new world. You assumed flitting from interest to interest meant you would join a creative group here and a community group there. Instead, you're discovering you feel like doing less than before your transition. Everything seems like too much. Likely including your job, cooking, driving here and there, or meeting friends. As if your world has stopped instead of revving up to a new level. You're exploring and flitting from place to place, either within yourself or physically. Just not as you expected. In the future, your flitting might be more outward than inward, as is true now. But it doesn't matter. There are no rules. Just as there are no universal rules of what you need to explore when you're not of 3D Earth. Allow yourself to float, act, talk, and be just as you allow an infant to do so as they explore their new world. You are doing the same in a new universal being while of the new Earth. The Earth you helped shift from fear to personal freedom, in joy, and love. So it is, you are creating a new universal being while of the Earth in this lifetime. So be it. Amen.